You're headed to Lestalem, right? I'll take you there, but no further.
Got it.
So, ready to ship out?
You bet. Let's fly.
Hold on tight, boys.
Look at that!
A red ship.
Rise and shine, Prince Charming. We're here. Sounds like a spot of trouble's popped up at the power plant. Wish I could help, but I'm powerless to do anything I'm not ordered to. I'll leave the keeping of the peace to you.
Of course.
We got this.
Good luck, boys.
Loving that outfit, Noct.
Why don't you wear one?
Oh, that's the only one. And if anyone stands a fighting chance in there, it's you. Forget about fashion and go.
Testing. Do you read me? Just wanted to thank you for offering to clear out those demons. That'll give me time to treat this mithril for you. There's a hunter who went in right ahead of you. I imagine there are too many for one to handle. But two of you should be fine. And a little heads up, we're getting some unstable readings from the generators inside. Too much power and the whole place could blow, so be quick.
Will do.
So, you my backup?
I thought we were partners.
Anyway, place is crawling with demons.
Wait a sec. You sound familiar.
Save the talk. We got hunting to do. Now, if we're done with the introductions, follow me. There they are. You ready to rumble?
Oh, yeah.
Some pretty fancy moves you got there. Reminds me of a certain king I know.
Fancy that. Not too shabby yourself. You make a good sparring partner.
You think so?
We're detecting a major power surge. She's gonna blow! Abort the mission and get out of there!
I ain't going to have unfinished business. Can't speak for him, though.
Then allow me. I this. Go ahead. Keep it up.
Will do. Now, let's scram.
Great work in there. As promised, here's your mithril. And, thank you for your hard work.
Sure.
Hey, big guy!
So the hunter who went on ahead?
The one and only. How you been, fellas?
Not bad. Whoa, someone did a number on you, though.
You should see the other guy. Anyway, I'm back. And better than ever.
Knocked? Gladdy? I can't believe it.
Hey, thanks for looking after her, Dustin.
So, Gladdy, did you apologize to Nacht for storming off like that?
He made it up to me in there.
The power plant? Oh, so you got your hands on some mithril. In that case, I'll go deliver it to Cid. You'll probably want to freshen up first anyway. Come and meet me in Kayim when you're ready.
Your Highness... I'm glad you're safe and well.
Not every day you see a stellar stone like that. Nice find.
This knocked?
What about it?
Anything happen while I was gone?
Yeah, the car got roomier.
Smart ass.
Too hot for you.
You can say that again.
Thanks for choosing Falstar.
Thank you.
looking forward to Iris' cooking.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that.
Aw, don't be that way. It's different when a girl cooks for you.
Having a nice morning? Till next time.
Let's get a shot with the lighthouse. Hair blowing in the breeze. We'll be seaside supermodels.
Seaside supermodels it is, then.
Oh, yeah! Seaside supermodels!
Take a shot from here.
Good call. Now it's picture time. Let me get this shot.
We ought to hold on to this one.
Aranea, she's a little different.
Certainly doesn't fit the Imperial Army profile.
Prince Noctis, even the Marshal came to say goodbye.
I guess it's goodbye for now.
Something I gotta get off my chest.
What's that?
I'm sorry. Sorry I wasn't there for your father. I swore an oath to protect the king, but I wasn't strong enough to uphold it.
Ain't nothing nobody could have done to stop what happened.
Yeah. I realize that.
But you need to realize just what you mean to the boys by your side.
I do.
Even if they can't solve your problems, you can't hide what's going on from them. It hurts like hell. Remember, those ain't your bodyguards. They're your brothers. Trust in them, always.
You can never have too many tools. Here, learn to wield not only weapons, but magic as well. Just remember, it's a destructive force that doesn't discriminate. I suggest putting someone in charge of it.
Huh.
Waiting for an invitation? Get your asses on board!
What's up?
Please, come back soon! We need our king!
Yeah, count on it.
The wedding day arrives, but alas, without the bride. Of course, we've come for the Hydrian, and you've gone to such lengths to prepare.
Merely my duty.
Ah, but for an outsider to lead the Imperial army must be a battle in and of itself. You've spoken to Lady Luna Freya.
No.
That obstinate secretary, standing in the way, while you rush off to slay the Hydrian for your poor sister's sake. I know the price of the Covenant.
You know, I've always wanted to go sailing like this.
Not many opportunities living in insomnia.
Out here, it's just us and the horizon. It's amazing. It's life-changing.
We've quite a ways to go until we reach Ultisha, so keep gushing to your heart's content.
When we step off the boat, we'll be in a foreign country.
The anticipation alone is a foreign sensation.
And to think this is where we were headed to begin with.
We've been through a lot.
And there's still more to come.
So next on the docket is Leviathan.
What sort of deity are we dealing with?
A serpent said to embody the roar and rage of the sea.
We'll have to see for ourselves.
Can't let Lady Luna Freya do all the heavy lifting.
You must be so psyched to see her.
Luna?
Yeah.
we need to make sure she's all right before anything else.
Indeed. Our well-being is top priority.
Don't like this going down on Imperial turf.
You think Lady Lunafreya's in danger there?
The Empire did invade Lucis for the ring. I have no faith their ruthless ambitions will stop short of harming the Oracle One.
Without the ring, the crystal's no more than a rock.
I suppose. Does anyone know how Lady Lunafreya came to have the ring?
It seems likely His Majesty entrusted it to her safekeeping back at the Crown City.
So she's held onto it this whole time, all the way to Alticia.
The ring is important, and so is Leviathan. But Luna comes first.
You know, I was thinking back to our encounter with Ravus. Do you recall an apparatus in place of his arm?
Yeah, I remember.
Seems he lost his old one in the invasion. But in its place, he seems to have acquired new power.
Power?
That would help explain how a son of Tenebrae suddenly came to command Niflheim's army.
Now that you mention it, his strength did seem sort of supernatural. I just chalked it up to the Oracle lineage.
His ancestry may be part of it, but that alone wouldn't account for his freakish strength.
I wonder what could have happened to him.
There's a disturbing rumor about. Lord Ravus has taken to brandishing His Majesty's sword.
My dad's?
Then what's the big idea behind that?
That his power's the same as the power of kings?
I cannot say for sure, but I have my doubts. Ravus wears the sword, yet doesn't wield it.
For all his newfound powers, he's still the Chancellor's lapdog, holding on to the enemy king's sword like some badge of honor.
It might help if we knew what he was after.
I can say.
What are the odds the Empire will crash the pool party with Leviathan?
Consider it a guarantee. They failed a god to prevent Noct from receiving his blessing. They'll do so again.
But we beat him to the big guy, thanks to our friendly guide.
Never know which way that one's gonna move next.
The Chancellor has an agenda all his own.
Sometimes it helps, like when he called off his army and let us escape.
But he was still a creep about it.
Well, feels like he's only helping us because he wants something. I just don't know what.
Reckon we'll see him again?
Certainly hope not.
Not your type?
No love lost for phonies.
As Gladio said, his actions are motivated not by altruism, but by self-interest. And when he does come to our aid, I see only condescension in his eyes.
Yeah, can't argue with that.
Ever think you think too much?
Sometimes, but it's always preferable to the alternative.
So, soon you'll have your old man's ring back.
Yeah, when we arrive in Alticia.
Good thing. To him, it was his heritage.
Is that what my dad said?
Carrying a royal line ain't a task to be taken lightly. For a small thing, that ring can sure weigh heavy. After he became king, I only ever saw his face in the paper.
Wait, weren't you at the coronation?
No, I was long gone from the city.
You must have been invited, at least.
Had a falling out of sorts with your old man. Right at the end of the trip.
You did?
I was given to understand you stayed in touch.
We buried the hatchet years later, but never talked face to face again. Shoulda paid a visit while I had the chance. Well, no use dwelling on it now. Got the regalia in the hold, but you're all gonna stay in Alticia for a good while, right?
Yes, we believe so.
In that case, I'll tune her up for y'all. Not that I'll have much to do, though. Well, with Cindy looking after the old girl.
If you say she's good, she must be great.
She was never afraid of hard work. Heaven knows she had a hard childhood.
A hard childhood?
He means her parents.
Lost them both when she was little. Was big enough to understand, though. And to hurt. But you wouldn't guess that, seeing her now.
Not at all. She's always so cheerful.
Well, that ought to tell you how far she's come.
Now, you must have seen your fair share of Alticia by now.
Yeah, only done been the once. Stayed a good while, though.
What's it like?
Big old city.
Big, okay.
Well, it ain't the Crown City.
different.
Got it.
You'll see for yourself. Foreign lands seldom lend themselves to trite explanations.
Change of scenery ought to do you good.
Well, I'm all talked out. Can't be far to Altisha now, right?
We'll be there in no time. Nice having the wind at our backs.
Lodgings are a fast order of business.
All work and no play? Makes Ignis a dull boy.
Someone has to be receiving it too.
Well, you're welcome to sleep in a while.
Ain't no hotel, but I know a fella has a place.
Hey now.
Wescombe ran with Reggie and me way back when.
Oh, was he the other one in that photo with the garage?
Yep. Runs himself a diner or a cafe or something. Go and see for yourselves.
Sure.
Does the place have a name?
McGee or Magoo or Mago. That's the one.
Nice.
You can count on old Wes. He'll chew your ears off.
The government issued a statement promising that the reasons behind awakening the Hydrian would be clarified in the ceremonial address.
Got a signal.
Delivering the address will be Lady Luna Freya, who was previously reported dead. This will mark her first public appearance since the violence that befell the signing ceremony.
Lady Luna Freya's gonna give a speech?
Sounds like it.
Lord knows. This world could use some wisdom.
Won't be much longer now, Noct.
Yeah.
Does this vessel have an entry permit?
Entry permit?
Relax. I got one. Here.
That's as old as they get. Seems in order. You may pass.
Prepared in advance.
Could say that. 30-odd years ago.
That's what the guy meant by old.
Lucky us, huh?
That could have ended badly.
What's next? Immigration?
What do you mean? There's still more?
Sir, what is the purpose of your visit?
Purpose, Ignis, a little help?
Oh, utterly hopeless.
We are scholars of the culinary arts, and we've come to study the renowned cuisine of your fair nation.
Is that so? I wish you an enlightening stay.
Another one you owe me.
You want to check Wescombe's place out?
Yeah, let's all go to Mago.
Perhaps we'll even make it in time for tea.
And we'd better start looking now.
It's a photographer's dream.
What a city.
Million gill question. What are we eating?
Let's grab a bite. They're extending the exhibit for Lady Lunafreya's wedding dress.
The Vivian Westwood? But wasn't that a memorial for her passing?
Well, now it's a memorial for her safe return. Let's go see it while we still can.
Oh, could that be the dress we read about in the papers?
Doubtless. The designer's name is the same.
Want to check it out?
That depends on the groom. Might still be a sore spot, what with his wedding getting called off.
Who says we can't call it back on? It can still happen.
True enough. Let's keep an eye out for it.
Shop till you drop.
Let's take a look inside.
This way to the dress?
Yep, same street as the estate.
Seems we're on the right track.
I gotta say, Aranea really impressed me today.
With her outfit?
Well, yeah, that too. It's just, I always had this impression that the Empire was filled with nothing but jerks.
She certainly doesn't fit the mold.
Really makes you wonder. You think she was okay with the raid on the Citadel?
Ask her yourself.
I wonder,
Is she really gonna leave the army?
You seem quite smitten with her.
Which one is it?
One is what?
Her or Cindy?
RNA or Cindy? Oh, wow. Okay, let me think about this for a sec.
I've no doubt both of them can wait.
I just feel like there's no point in going into work anymore. Like I'm not welcome.
You're overthinking it. Come on, let's go somewhere you're all with.
Where do you want to go?
Excuse me, could you point us to the shop with Lady Lunafreya's dress?
Just follow this road towards the Secretary's estate. Then brace yourself for the insane crowds.
Oh, well, I guess that's to be expected. Thank you.
She's a big deal.
Big? Think you mean huge?
You truly get the sense.
Let's head back to our room.
Did you see that over there, Noct?
What about it?
What's a good place to stay?
Is it evening already?
Time flies when you're having fun.
I'm so glad that Lady Luna's safe.
Gondola!
Care for a ride?
Did you see that, Noct?
What is it?
Peace be unto the province.
Hungry.
good place to stay.
You know, we did struggle a bit without you.
Oh, yeah?
Couldn't get the fire going.
You could've just cast a spell.
Kinda overkill, don't you think?
Hopeless. Next time I'll show you hacks how it's done.
The war is won, yet they continue harvesting for soldiers.
Now that you mention it, flavor of the day is...
Oh, the dress is so beautiful. I want mine to be like that.
And it shall be, my love, as surely as I am your Prince Noctis.
Looks like the prince has a following as well.
Not bad. For a symbol of the peace. One hell of a crowd.
And that's the dress. My word.
Everyone looks so happy. And it's all because of this one dress.
Yeah.
Real glad for you that Lady Luna Freya is safe and sound.
Yeah.
Well, that settles it. You gotta make it happen. Become a symbol of the peace. After we tie up all the loose ends, let's think about the ceremony.
A fine idea.
Yeah, I'll think about it.
Bet the view's even better from a gondola. Now I see why people flock from far and wide to the walls of water.
This place is so romantic.
Then you get to enjoy it with us.
All three of us.
You are a lucky man.
He just stood there, staring at the church and looking all sad. Can you blame him? His sister was supposed to get married there. But...
get me a glass of this.
Then why don't you?
Yeah, let's hit up Mago later.
Question. What are we eating?
Greetings. You are not from here. Alessio's my name. Coin collecting's my game. Oracle Ascension coins specifically. Have you any? If you're willing to part with some, I'll gladly trade you a token of equal value. Bring some more coins, and I'll have something special in store for you.
His arm's so cool. I mean, not like I actually want one of my own or anything.
No, dude, I totally feel the same way. They say that thing's got, like, superpowers.
The Empire makes some sick stuff.
Splendid. Where are we off to?
Hey there. Have a good look. Come back anytime.
Gentlemen, it has been a pleasure.
Welcome to Accordo, lads. Sid mentioned you'd be dropping in. Wuskamarmar, as you've gathered. My word, you've grown, little prince. But of course. You were only a babe at the... So this is your maiden visit. Enjoying it so far? You doubtless have many questions, so ask away.
This country is a part of the Empire, isn't it?
Oh, you're wary. I understand. But there's no need to jump at every shadow. Just be aware that the terms of our independence grant the Empire free rein to come and go as they please.
We'll bear that in mind.
It's admittedly a one-sided arrangement. Most everything we do requires Niflheim's permission. And they wouldn't knowingly permit the Oracle to appear before the public. How our government spun that is quite a mystery.
You really think Luna will make an address?
If every recent radio broadcast is to be trusted, absolutely.
Where is Lady Luna Freya?
In the city somewhere. But no one has caught so much as a glimpse of her. The media has been conspicuous in its silence on the matter, which speaks volumes of government intervention. That certainly explained the rumors of disgruntled Imperial officers leaving the city.
Has anything changed with Leviathan?
For now, it's business as usual at port. But word is the government will soon open the altar of the Tide Mother.
In preparation for the rite.
Ah, but on the other hand, they're scrambling to stockpile emergency provisions. This begs the question. If they're anticipating that the Hydrian will wreak havoc, why would they allow the rite to proceed?
Do you see lots of Nifs around here?
We do, sometimes even at my place. Theirs is a familiar presence, and the citizens don't think much of it. Though the High Commander did cause a stir when he showed up the other day.
Ravus.
So soon after they fell the Archean and Lucis, his arrival fuels rumors that they will next come to Altisha. The Empire's not content ruling all the land. They want the heavens as well. Well, if you need anything else, you know where to find me.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
My dear Camellia, it's been a while.
I heard about your distinguished guests.
Ah, Yuvani.
Gentlemen, I won't waste your time. My name is Camellia Klostra.
First Secretary of the Accordo Protector.
You should know, we have Lady Luna Freya in our care. And the Empire demands we surrender her.
What?
Yet I am loath to acquiesce unless we stand to profit. Hence I've come to discuss terms with the King of Lucis. If you've a mind to talk, come to my estate.
She can be oblique at the best of times, but I assure you, her heart is in the right place.
Oh, okay.
At any rate, you must be weary from your journey. Might I suggest you seek your beds for now and ponder matters anew in the morning?
Yeah, I think we'll do just that.
She doesn't rub shoulders with the Empire by choice. Everybody knows she wants independence.
Maybe she can ally herself with the Prince now that he's come back to life.
Wait, is that why she went to Maga? Oh my gosh.
Remember, your heart is yours to follow, should you ever need.
So, someone caught the secretary at Majo again.
She and the barkeep sure are friendly.
There's gotta be something going on. She wouldn't spend so much time at that place if there wasn't.
Fantastic. Call when you need a ride back.
Let's grab a bite.
How about a ride-a-la on the gondola?
I just feel like there's no point in going to work anymore. Like, I'm not welcome.
Kentiana.
Ahead lies a future uncertain, yet sure is the astral memory wherein the king may walk.
Greetings.
Let's call it a day. Above at long last.
Well taken.
I swear, half your photos are selfies.
Hashtag sorry, not sorry. Well, guess we need to go talk to Camellia.
Yeah, like we have any other option.
There's no telling how events will unfold. Let us prepare before making our way.
Yeah, she can sit tight a while.
Gentlemen, it has been a pleasure.
We should be pretty close to a famous photo spot.
Let's check it out.
Yeah, let's go.
It's a little chilly.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You did good.
You've improved.
Come on, come to Papa.
Stop reeling.
Not. You can show a bit of emotion, you know.
Respool the line before it's too late.
Thank you.
I'm all fished out. And I haven't even fished.
Yeah.
Got a big one. Look at the size of that thing. Ease off on the reeling. Was a huge one, too.
The line's still okay, you think?
So, care to take a cruise? Fantastic. Call when you need a ride back.
Take a shot from here.
Good call. Now it's picture time. Let me get this shot. The gang's all here, see? Us?
Where should we stay tonight?
Splendid. Where are we off to? Gentlemen, it has been a pleasure.
It is quite lovely at twilight.
Yeah, but there's something lonely about it, too.
Thank you for coming.
No sweat. First things first. Thanks for coming to greet us in person.
It's the least I could do for a king. Wescombe didn't extend me an invitation, so I decided to extend my own. Though circumstances have changed, both the king and the oracle are finally in Alticia.
You said that you have Luna in your care. She better be safe.
She is. But whether she remains so depends wholly upon you. Now let me ask some questions of my own. Why does the Oracle seek to awaken the Hydrian?
She wants to forge a covenant so I can receive Leviathan's blessing.
The answer I wanted to hear. And yet, king or not, it can't be a simple affair for you to receive a god's blessing. I may be frank. The potential chaos worries me. You know better than most what took place in Lucis with Archean. Tell me, what happened?
I met Titan, and he gave me his power.
Just like the legends, though the Empire doesn't like the way the story goes. Even as we speak, they mobilize their forces. It seems there's no avoiding chaos. It will most likely come to war. However, I don't care to host a battle on my soil. The gods and the Empire be damned.
Much you can do when it comes to gods.
You'd suggest I accept my city's destruction? Nothing of worth to contribute? Without further ado, let us talk terms. If you wish to hold the right, you must ensure my citizens' safety and aid in their evacuation.
Do as you ask.
I'm pleased to hear it. As long as the people's safety is assured, I have no qualms with your right. And that is not all. Once the right has begun, I will not be accountable for what follows. You are on your own.
Not a problem. We know how to take care of ourselves.
Thank you. I'm sorry we cannot do more. But as I'm sure you are aware, few armies can stand against the might of the Imperial fleet. That is all for the terms. To review, you are to ensure our citizens' safety and engage the Empire. Do we have an agreement?
We'll help however we can.
Lest you forget, this is a business deal. A flippant attitude will earn you a flippant response. A final warning, though I doubt it'll come to it. My duty is to my citizens. Should any harm befall them, there will be a reckoning for both King and Oracle.
All right. You do what you must for your people.
You're just like your father.
Thanks.
You've made the right decision.
Madam, it's time.
Assign three of your own for the evacuation effort. Whom you choose is up to you. According to our intel, the Imperial fleet will be four warships strong, Steel yourselves for a full-scale battle. I have confidence you will do well by us, and you can expect the same in return. I can't promise something I can't help.
Of course. You certainly opened up to them, though.
What can I say? I have a soft spot for the young and tragic. They've lost Regis. They've lost the crystal. Was it so long ago the last oracle was taken from them? We've seen the Empire go mad these 10-odd years.
During the rite, we must see to it the Empire does not harass Leviathan.
Gonna be tough to pull off before the King receives her power.
And with three of us on evacuation detail.
Indeed, the best we can realistically do is to help the Hydrian help herself.
What kind of help you talking about?
Just like Titan, the Empire will seek to immobilize Leviathan.
Oh, with the harpoon things?
If we can dislodge them from the goddess, she will have a fighting chance.
Sounds good in theory, but don't push it. It's pointless, unless you can get that blessing.
Stay flexible, stay alert.
All right, will do.
If worse comes to worse, you can threaten to throw the trident into the sea. Then they'll listen. In the meantime, it will be well guarded. Better than the Oracle herself.
Understood. I shall reclaim it at the altar.
Remember, you'll be under Imperial watch.
Right.
Think of it as a necessary evil in order to forge the Covenant.
I am in your debt.
Once it's over, you may go as you please, but you do so without our protection.
So be it.
You'd better get going. Your public is waiting for you.
Knocked. You in position?
Yep.
Don't forget the plan.
You guys too.
Of course.
Talk about a crowd. Like the whole city's come to watch.
Dear friends, I stand before you today with little hope the words I speak shall reach beyond these walls. For slowly but surely, the light fades from our world, and as it does, the shadows shall loom ever longer until all succumbs to the darkness. Darkness that evokes terror, hatred, and sorrow in the hearts of men. The ashes of Lucis, a dream of peace, twisted into a nightmare of death and destruction, claiming innumerable lives and leaving myriad souls to suffer.
Luna.
Yet I beg you, do not surrender to despair. Have faith, for our gods watch over us. By their blessings, by the stars that light the heavens above, our world will be delivered from the perils of the dark. I stand before you here in Altisha to call upon Leviathan, goddess of the seas, spirit of the deep. By the sacred rite, I will commune with the Hydrian. But first, I offer you my solemn vow. On my honor as Oracle, I will not rest until the darkness is banished from our world and the light is restored. Bless you all. It is I, Luna Freya, blood of the Oracle. Goddess of the seas, I beseech you, enter into this covenant that the king might reclaim the stone.
Do this.
I know what you must know. That the King of Kings is to drive the darkness from our star. It is in receiving mercy that men offer praise, and in shedding grace that the gods solicit worship. I vow, the king will prove himself worthy.
Noct, Prompto's headed your way.
But what about you guys?
We'll wait below. There's only room for two.
Noct, jump!
What?
No time for questions!
Man! What was this?
New ride we borrowed from the Nifts! This will get us in close!
Serious?
Here she comes!
I got this! Hey! Your power! Give it up! Don't you understand? I'm the king! I need your power! So the only way you'll help me is if I take you down? Yeah!
About that ring. On second thought, you let him have it. And do remind him about the crystal. Oh, Prince, your bride awaits.
I will pass the ring to the rightful king. When the prophecy is fulfilled, all enthralled to darkness shall know peace.
Thank you. Noctis? Luna? So, you found your way here.
And you found me.
A chance to see you once more. Who would have thought?
What do you mean? Why wouldn't you see me?
Because my prayers have been answered. My calling fulfilled.
That doesn't have to come between us.
You are the one, Noctis. The stars shine for you now. That which is yours by right shall be restored to you. Do you remember the flowers of Tenebrae? It seems so long ago. You'll find they await you still, blooming from hill to vale.
Will you be there?
Would that I could join you. But this moment will have to be enough.
It's not right. All I wanted was to save you.
When the world falls down around you and hope is lost. When you find yourself alone amid a lightless place. Look to the distance. Know that I am there. And that I watch over you always. Farewell. Dear Noctis.
Back with us. I'll tell the others. Though it may take a bit.
You're hurt.
A small sacrifice in the greater battle.
And Luna?
she has passed. Umbra left that for you.
So, we're gonna roll through Tenebrae.
Not before visiting the royal tomb at Kartanica.
You're sure you're up to that?
The wounds have mended. Eyesight's a matter of time.
The hell is wrong with you? We're not stopping in Tenebrae. You need to grow up and get over it.
I am over it. I'm here, aren't I?
Maybe when you're not too busy moping, you can look around and give a shit about someone worse off than you.
Let go of me.
How's that ring fit you? You'd rather carry it around than wear it? She gave her life so you could do your duty, not so you could sit around feeling sorry for yourself.
You don't think I know that?
You don't! Ignis took one for you too. And for what?
Enough! Gladio.
You think you're a king, but you're a coward.
Shut up! Don't do this! I
get it, all right?
I get it!
Then get a grip. Pull your head out of your ass already.
Knocked!
Leave him.
I hope at least one ancestor of yours had the sense to build his tomb somewhere safe.
There's men in black are spooking me out.
Shh, don't talk about others.
Much longer. Not long,
dear. The way you were looking at her.
But I wasn't looking at anyone.
High Commander Poray has been deemed accountable for Altisha's tragedy and sentenced to execution. Lord Ravus Nox Floray was promoted to the Imperial Army's top post amid the turmoil of the failed peace talks. The High Commander's primary responsibility was restoring stability to Lucis, yet his campaign against the Hydrian ended in disaster, incurring monumental losses for the Empire and collateral damage to the area.
Still no sign of Lady Lunafreya anywhere.
He's not looking good.
What I wouldn't give to see her again. They charge us an arm and a leg for this slop?
That's Imperial quality for you. Should have let a chef from a Cordo handle the catering. To the dining car?
So you can feast your eyes on that other girl.
Give me a break. I'm just hungry is all.
Anything in Cartanica worth stopping for?
Doubt it, but we'll be there long enough to find out.
One step closer to finding the next tomb.